Hello world, Becca here from Inside the Square, coming at you with another CSS tutorial. Today, we're going to get a little in-depth in how to style hyperlinks for any text type. So right here, I have an example in my demo site. We've got an active link for heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, and a normal paragraph link. Now in the style editor in Squarespace, I'll show you right here, if we go into design, site styles, and I'll go ahead and click on this piece right here, we can see that in the content, you can actually change the color of links in normal paragraph text. Pretty cool, right? Well, I want to change more than the color. So the most common request that I get is to remove the underline on active links. A lot of people just don't like that style. I mean, it's been around since the beginning of the interwebs, right? So let's go ahead and check out that one. We'll go to design and then custom CSS. And this code is beneath the video, but I'm going to break it down for you. First and foremost, we need to identify which type of text we want to remove the link from. Let's say just heading ones, we'll type the letter H and the number 1, followed by the letter A. That A stands for active link. Really important to have that letter A. Now after that, I'm just going to say border bottom style, none, and you'll see the underline is gone. Let's say we want to remove it from just heading 2. I'll change that 1 to a 2, and now you'll see that underline is gone. Paragraph text is represented by the letter P. That's the normal text there. And again, underline is gone. So if you want all of them at the same time, you can type H1A for active link, comma, H2A for active link, comma, H3A for active link, and then PA for the active link. And there we go. Now, really important to note, we do have to have a space between the character and the letter. You'll see if I remove that from paragraph, our line shows up on the bottom again, and we don't want that. So make sure that space is there. This code is beneath the video, so you can just copy and paste to remove the active underline link there. Otherwise, if you're up for it, let's talk about some more styles. So I've scrolled down here to give us a couple of options. So removing the underline, again, most common request. Some of the other things you can do is change the font color on things that aren't just paragraph text. So let's take a look at that one really quick. Again, this is changed in the site styles in Squarespace. These other links don't actually change color. So let's take a look at those. For H1, H2, and H3, I'll leave those here in my code. We'll go ahead and add the text color. And then I'll just add my favorite, let's see, 50BDB8, there we go. That's my favorite teal color. And now you'll notice the text itself is actually teal. So another option that we have is to work with hovers. So automatically in Squarespace, it does kind of this spotlight thing where it'll change the color when you hover over it. Let's say we just want to change the active link color over a hover. So I will go ahead and type the word hover after the letter A for each one of these heading types that I'm talking about here. Okay, so now you'll see they've returned their original color, but as soon as I hover over it, it's going to change to that teal that I love so much. So far, so good? Awesome. So the last thing I'd like to show you is how to change the background color. If you know a lot about CSS, you can get really creative and add gradients and all kinds of cool stuff like that. Otherwise, you can just work with a solid color. Let's say background color, we'll make it that teal, and we'll change the color of the font to be a solid white so it's easy to see. I'm going to go ahead and add the text important to this piece of code here because that's going to let the browser know that it needs to read this code over the standard CSS. So now when we hover over it, the link now changes to that different color. All right, so again, the things you can change here that I recommend you playing around with: the underline, the font color, the background color, and of course, hover effects. That's it for this week's tutorial. Oh yeah, almost forgot. Most important part, my friends, select save when you're done. All right, that's it for today and thanks for watching. Have fun with your Squarespace website. Ready for more? Head on over to insidethesquare.co for more tutorials and exclusive content you won't find anywhere else. That's insidethesquare.co.